Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this solar eclipse in deep space with colorful surrounding clouds of gas and dust radiating from the solar winds. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create the basic eclipse, and in part two, we'll add stars, radiating gases and dust, and make the eclipse glow with intense heat. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Let's name it Eclipse. Make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. For the background, click Other. If you're working on an early version of Photoshop and don't see it, I'll tell you what to do in a moment. Pick Black and click OK on both windows. Another way to fill your background with black is to first make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Since black is your foreground color, press Alt-Delete on Windows or Option-Delete on a Mac. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Elliptical Marquee tool, go near the center of your document, and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circle approximately this size. Fill the selection with any color. I'll fill it with white, and since white is my background color, I'll press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To center the circle on your document, first press Ctrl or Command A to select it all, and click your Move tool. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then, deselect it. Reduce the fill to zero. This makes the circle completely transparent, but it'll retain the full visibility of any effects that we add to it. Double-click the thumbnail of the circle to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, the noise is zero, and the color is white. The spread is zero, and the size is 40 pixels. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the color is white. The technique is softer, the source is edge, the choke is zero, and the size is 15 pixels. Then click OK. Make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Temporarily hide layer 1. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the composite snapshot. Open your Gradient tool and click the Reflection Gradient icon. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black-white gradient box and click OK. Go to the middle of the circle and press and hold Shift as you drag out the gradient line to the edge of the outer glow and release. At the top and bottom, let's bring back a little bit of the glow. To do this, make layer 1 visible and active. Decrease its opacity to 10%. Make the top layer active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Let's name it Lens Flare. Fill the empty layer with black and change the blend mode to screen. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make the lens type 105mm prime and the brightness 80%. Drag the lens flare to a position that approximates the location of the edge of your eclipse. Then click OK. The lens flare probably won't be exactly where you want it to be, so to reposition it, press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool and drag it over the glow. We want to hide the outer areas of the lens flare. To do this, click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the lens flare. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Open your brush tool and brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make sure the hardness is 0% and press Enter or Return. Make the opacity 100%. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket keys on your keyboard. I'll make the size of my brush 700 pixels. Keep in mind, the lens flare is presently being hidden or masked out by the layer mask. By brushing white over the layer mask, it'll reveal the lens flare next to it. Center your cursor over the point where your lens flare is and click 3 or 4 times to reveal it. Next, we'll add small hotspots on the other side of the eclipse. Make the eclipse active and reduce the size of your brush. Reduce its opacity to 80% and carefully brush over the edge of the eclipse in a few spots. Make the top layer active and click the new layer icon to make a new layer. Control click or command click on the thumbnail of layer 1 to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Click the chain link. This will link the width and the height together, so whatever percentage we type into one will be repeated in the other. Type into either field 110%. Then, click the check mark at the top to accept the transform. Go to Edit and Stroke. For the width, type in 30 pixels. The color is white and the location is center. Then, click OK. Deselect it and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 100 pixels and click OK. In part 2, we'll complete our solar eclipse with stars, radiating clouds of gases and dust, and illuminate the rim with intense heat. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.